The male in an ideal world wants to mate with as many females as possible in order to pass its genes on to as many offspring in the next generation as it possibly can. The female, on the other hand, is only able to produce the single clutch of eggs, and so she wants them to be fertilized by the optimum male that she can find. So the males are looking for quantity, and the females, on the other hand, are looking for quality.
Again, like the antechinus, but there's one major difference. Female bonking beetles are way more discerning than their marsupial counterparts. The hogweed female would ditch a current partner for a better reproductive proposition, even going so far as to ejaculate the sperm of the last male they copulated with if a more attractive fella comes along. Given the choice, she'd happily mate with multiple partners. The problem is, the males are a bit clinging.
When the males find a female, they will hold on for as long as they can because they know that if they let go of that female, she'll go off and find another male. And if the male that she finds is superior to the one that was there before, she can reject the sperm from the first male and use the sperm from the superior male to fertilize her eggs. So it's in the male's interest to hold on like a living chastity belt. He prevents her, by his presence, from mating with anybody else.
In bonking beetles, the final male a female mates with is usually the father of her offspring, a phenomenon scientists call last male sperm precedence. The male beetle's flesh might be willing and the desire for multiple partners strong, but in reality, it's just not an option. Turns out, he's a one-woman beetle.
In order to mate with other females, he has to let go of the one that he's already got. So a bird in the hand is effectively worth two in the bush. He's going to hang on to this female unless it's very easy for him to transfer onto a second female. So even though he would like to mate with a lot of individuals, it's not in his interest to let go of the one that he's got.
To become a living chastity belt is no easy thing, particularly when you're hanging in there for as long as 5 days. The male bonking beetle has to hold on for dear lust. Luckily, he's got a bit of kit that's perfectly adapted for the job.
The males of the hogweed bonking beetle have got these claspers which allow them to hold on to the female and make it quite difficult for her to dislodge him once they're in position. The females will attempt to kick the males off in some situations, and sometimes are successful.
And the female comes equipped with some adaptive tactics of her own, the just say no position, maneuvering her abdomen so a male physically can't enter her. The disagreements start before the bonking has even begun.
Well, I think what we're looking at is a classic example of an evolutionary arms race, that the males and the females have slightly different agendas that would maximize their reproductive success. And so they're competing with each other effectively, and they're modifying their morphology to best suit their particular strategy.
This evolutionary arms race is known as sexual conflict, when a male and female have different genetic interests. Both sexes want to pass on their genes. They just have very different strategies for how that should be done. What they do have in common is where their amorous rendezvous should take place.